to becoming the Pac-10's all-time leading scorer.
He would pass Sean Elliott from Arizona.
The white flag for the wins of UCLA. The top seed in the West. Gerald Matkins immediately goes to the free throw line just 20 seconds into this game. The Bruins making their 28th NCAA appearance. And they can't go in front on two missed free throws by Matkins. No good, and Murray clears it out. The plane on the baseline, partially blocked.
When Robert Morris played Kansas 2 years ago, there's going to be a turnover right there. UCLA was also in that region, which upset Kansas. They beat UAB in the first round, so they have seen Robert Morris in that Jim Herrick game. So during a little pinch off before the game.
We know he didn't give one tonight. McLean looks for Butler in the cutter and can't get it.
Let him move! UCLA really struggling offensively against this man-to-man defense.
Action three won't go. Nice job defensively by Robert Morris. And the rebound is Joe Folletti.
Robert Morris keeping UCLA off the offensive boards. Only one shot.
Footer short by Ricky Cannon. And Ty Sedney brings it back for the Bruins.
Good transition defense by Robert Morris. UCLA likes to run.
Murray.
No foul.
In and out. Folletti's got three rebounds already. Well, we're a couple minutes in and no score. Tennyson draw. Murray gets it ahead to Matkins. And Matkins walked with it.
Well, there's a lot of contact. They're letting him play. The biggest thing is for the players not to get frustrated.
And as you might expect, the crowd in the corner of the Colonial.
You would think that Robert Morris might be a little tight, but they've been here too many times. UCLA looks like they're the ones really tight.
More than 2 minutes, 15 seconds in, and no score. Joe Folletti trying to change that, comes up short. One thing the Colonials do look intimidated by is when they get down on the offensive end and put a shot up. But they're playing great defense.
Their transition defense has been super. UCLA is moving. Kind of stifled as far as what they want to do on their offensive end when they want to get that break going.
Dave Tennyson on top. Penetrate. Still no score. Folletti's got another rebound, though. And a little hook inside is a goaltending call on Murray. They'll give Ricky Cannon credit for that one.
Can you tell who they're for?
The Colonials have to feel good about how things are going. Just 3 minutes into the game, and although they lead by only two, UCLA hasn't shown them anything yet that they haven't been able to deal with.
For memory for UCLA, here you are, you have the number one seed out in the West. You hope you have a lot of fans here, but boy, the crowd is way against them. And they really have to pull themselves together and calm down and really get into this game. They're kind of uptight right now.
I remember a lot of Arizona State fans, no doubt, at this game, and Bill Frieder's group's not here, so they'll boo UCLA anyway. entry pass in low. Nowhere near for Butler, though, and back come the Colonials.
UCLA not having a true center in that post position, but they've got some good leapers in there.
Comes out of the pile with it. UCLA 0 for 4 from the field. McLean had it stripped. Wade Timmerson makes it 4-0, 4 minutes in. Murray way outside. Buries the three. There'll be some tired fans before this one's over.
You're all that yelling.
Edney picks up Timmerson on top. Cannon works for a 14-footer, and McLean will clear it off.
Cannon so far has been the offense in the half-court game for Robert Morris.
Murray, another three. This one won't go. And the Colonials put it up on the other end. Myron Walker nowhere near off the glass that time. 4-3, Robert Morris with 15-10 remaining first half.
UCLA setting up in their half-court game. They're the type of team that needs to get things going defensively. Nice step in the passing lane by Cannon. The passes really are not sharp for UCLA.
That's four turnovers already against the Bruins. Is a shooter. He won't give up because he's 0-for so far. That one's partially blocked though. McLean takes it out of midair.
UCLA trying to create a tickle, but it's all been Robert Morris right now. Murray hitting 1 3-pointer.
Atkins really battling inside with Shelton Carney. And he got away from Carney momentarily. Joe Folletta. And they're going to call him for the foul, trying to get position on the rebound.
I feel like the way Joe Folletta plays the game. Sets picks, works hard on defense, gets down, blocks people out.
14-16, remaining first. Chris's wife, we understand, is real excited about it, too. 4-3, Robert Morris, early in the ballgame. I think Chris Godwin would do Sunday's game with no clothes on if Robert Morris could upset number 1. Bruins with more turnovers than points up until now. McLean's first basket. 5-4 Bruins. That's their first lead. Magdy Bilal has checked in for the lineup for Robert Morris.
Robert Morris really spreading the offense out, making the defense spread out. Tracy Murray reaching in. It's not the defense that's causing Robert Morris to go out away from the basket. They are creating it themselves.
First foul on Murray.
Hey, spot's rolling. Here we go.
Timmerson to inbound. Shelton Carney, Myron Walker. And Robert Jones on the court for the Colonials.
Good penetration by Timmerson. UCLA still cannot run the ball. Defense getting back by Robert Morris.
UCLA, they're starting five in there. Matson, Butler, Murray, McLean, and Edmonds.
The biggest thing for UCLA is just to be patient on offense those first 3-4 minutes of the game. They look real tight coming out of that timeout. They look a lot more relaxed.
7-0 Bruin run. Murray with 5 of those points, and they're up 7-4. Walker ran out of room, got it inside to Bilal. Magdy Bilal cuts the UCLA lead back to one.
Well, all have started the last 14 games coming in here. They inserted Cannon in that middle.
Playing a little runner on the baseline, trying to get his own rebound. And he paid for it. That's his first foul.
John was playing really struggling as far as trying to get a good open shot. He's had one when he hit around the free throw line.
Jim Herrick in his fourth year as the head coach of the Bruins. And with one of the most talented teams he has had. Henderson can't connect for three, and a fight for the rebound. This foul will go on Robert Jones.
Robert Morris really attacking the offensive glass, trying to create something as far as the boards are concerned.
And we've got a timeout with 11 minutes and 57 seconds.
To Evansville, and the Purple Aces lead at 14 to 12. There they are, the UTEP Miners on the bench, talking with their coach, Don Haskins.
And Jim missed the tournament last year, first time in 7 years they missed. And here are those unusual uniforms you see on the Purple Aces, Jim.
The sleeved uniforms. A little tribute to an old coach.
Arad McCutcheon, Hall of Famer, great coach at Evansville in years past.
How about East Tennessee State, 3:41 before the half. And the Buccaneers lead the three-seed Arizona by five.
9 of 14 three-point shots so far. This is a club, I said, experienced. And they're used to winning championships, and they played a very good game at Arizona just last year.
We've had a 13-seed win today. And that was the Raging Cajuns of southwestern Louisiana, but this is a 14-seed over a three at the moment. Princeton and Syracuse are nearing the start of the second half with Syracuse leading 28-23. The meantime, back out in Tempe, UCLA's lead now 9-6 over Robert Morris.
UCLA should have much too much power for Robert Morris in this game. You remember, there was another team that missed the tournament last year for a different reason, NCAA suspension. Back in the fold, used to be a junior college, did Robert Morris, located right near the Pittsburgh airport, but playing fine basketball.
Okay, more updates coming up at halftime, but right now let's send you back to Brad and Ann.
All right, Jim. Robert Morris right now for Jared Durham, only 3 out of 16 from the field. That's not helping him much, but still there within striking distance, trailing the Bruins by only 3 with 11:10 to go first half. And Bubba Donnelly with the basketball is just checked in for the Colonials.
Robert Morris getting more shots at the basket and out rebounding these guys.
Robert Jones got in close. That shot partially blocked and back from the Bruins with a three-point edge. Murray inside. Tracy Murray's got 7.
Great touch by Tracy Murray. Went up and then all of a sudden turned his wrist to kind of roll it in.
Dave Timmerson, Bubba Donnelly, Myron Walker, and Robert Jones on the floor for the Colonials. And Robert Morris, here's Walker, still looking for a field goal. Still looking for a field goal. Rebound comes out to Edney.
Jerry Mackin's the best defensive player for UCLA. He's checked Chris Mills down and an awful lot of players this season and in the past. And he's doing the same thing as Myron Walker right now.
Still UCLA ball. Joe Folletto will check back in for the Colonials. Don McClain with 4 points and 3 rebounds early, and the field goal percentage has been horrendous for Robert Morris. But holding UCLA scoreless the first 4.5 minutes helped him stay within striking distance. Now we approach the midway point of the first half. And a foul on Ricky Cannon.
McClain making some moves offensively, good pivot moves, and a good thing going
on. Well, Don McClain, the All-American, will go back to the free throw line, where he's 2 for 2 so far tonight.
And he leads the nation with 92% on the free throw line. And, you know, Mark Dellen, the SID from UCLA, is trying to find out from the NCAA whether he is the first big man to lead the country.
Whoop, they had one come out. This one we gave him the build-up on that 92% free throw shooting. Donald, three-pointer. Got it. And this little guy can light it up when he gets hot. 12-9 Bruins. Now the backcourt has Edney at 5'10", guarded by Rich Bubba Donnelly at 5'10". Feet inside to Ricky Cannon, knocked away. The guy they used to call the Jewel when he was a player at Duquesne, Jared Durham. Walker will sit down and Shelton Carney comes back in for the Colonial. Derek Martin and John Tarver check in for UCLA. And Jared Durham also goes back to his bench as Andre Williams checks into his backcourt. And he'll be the trigger man on the baseline.
UCLA one of the few teams that man-to-man the out-of-bounds play.
And a lot of new faces on the court right now for both clubs.
Oh.
I don't know who's getting credit for that. Maybe Folletta. The Bruin lead back to a point. McLean. Rebound comes off to Robert Morris. Who Shelton Carney cleared the glass.
UCLA has a lot of quick athletes and they're a quick team and they're not running a quick half-court game. Not that you want to rush things, but you need some passes and just six set. They're going to call a down right there. Turnover for Robert Morris, but UCLA needs to get things going and they just have slowed things down.
And O'Bannon checks in for the Bruins. And Mitchell Butler gets his first breather of the night. This is our final game of day one here at the West Regional in Tempe, Arizona. And the Colonials of Robert Morris hanging right in with the number one seed in the West, the Bruins of UCLA. 12-11, Bruins lead.
Derek Martin, a senior for UCLA, started the last 3 years. And Sean Carver was the player that Tyus Edney took his starting spot. Sean Carver has started all year except in this game.
Carver got that one off the glass to put the Bruin lead back at 3. Williams. And a shot. No good. And again it goes in. And let's see. And I'll hold this one off. Valetta got credit for the last one that was much like this one.
Well, he's so aggressive on the board. And actually, they're going to call it on number 32, Shelton Carney.
And so they walk it down to the other end with Robert Morris already over the limited foul.
It was on Timmerson, but I don't know who he was around the play.
It sure didn't look like Timmerson to me either. That's what they have up on the scoreboard.
Now
they just change it back to Carney. That makes more sense.
We have to trust our eyes.
I guess so. Now McLean gets the rest. Tracy Murray at the free throw line. And has he been something this year? 21.5 points a game. Third in the Pac-10 scoring. Balao clears off the miss by Murray. Bruins leading by 4 with 7:15 to go first half. This one has the makings of a 50-45 game. Dowling, air ball. O'Bannon had a piece of it, and Murray picked up the loose ball.
O'Bannon was a redshirt last year, blew out his knee and had reconstructed surgery.
Driving all the way across the baseline. Carver, he gets it back and takes the outside jumper just inside the three-point line. UCLA with its biggest advantage, 17-11.
Well, you feel that UCLA is just slowly going to creep away, but Robert Morris has really played solid offensively and defensively.
Bilal, that's a strong move. Magdy Bilal with four. Rodney Zimmerman in the UCLA lineup. So is Derek Martin. So is Tracy Murray.
Murray fourth in the nation in three-point field goal percentage, 50%.
11 points already for Murray. And he's 4-6 from the field. Now the lead stretched out to 7. Valletta tried a little jump stop, and it was more like a jump walk. With 5 minutes, 50 seconds. UCLA, after shutting off 0-for-5 in this ballgame, have warmed up 7 of their last 9. And the Bruins have a 7-point advantage, their largest margin. Brad Nessler and Ann Myers with you. Although Robert Morris is hanging right in here with the number one seed. Ann.
They really are, but they're not shooting the ball very well. Offensively, they're getting some difficult shots to go in.
2 upsets here earlier today. New Mexico State was a winner, so was Southwestern Louisiana. But then Louisville held their seed, the number 8 seed, beating number 9 Wake Forest earlier tonight.
They're going to call a foul on Don McLean.
And here's how it looks so far. The number 13 and number 12 seeds advance, and then Louisville with a win over Wake Forest earlier tonight. And now the number 1 seed trying to hold off number 16. And of course, the 16th seed's never beaten the number 1 since the expanded format of the NCAA tournament. With 5 minutes remaining first half, Robert Morris still can't seem to find a decent shot.
They keep trying.
They're shooting under 25% right now.
They're getting good penetration to the basket, but they just don't have the guys that are going to put the ball down and try and block charge. They're looking to pass the ball off to their teammates.
Colonials won the Northeast Tournament with an 85-81 win over Merritt. They come in with a 19-11 record. And they got a foul on the inbound, and that one will go against Rodney Zimmerman. There's what we were talking about. Robert Morris, 6 of 24. UCLA at the 50% mark.
Easy now. Come on.
Carver.
I don't think Robert Morris is trying to hold the ball at all. They're just trying to get a good shot off.
Last time he threw one up from out there, it was an air ball. That time Bubba Donnelly buried it, his second 3 of the night, and now it's a 4-point game again. Donnelly loves to shoot the 3-pointer, and he's shown it to us tonight from out there. Inside O'Bannon. Nice move with the left hand. UCLA by 6 with 4 minutes to play first half.
Robert Morris also looking for a good shot and running the clock down, making UCLA play defense.
Walker hasn't scored until now. That's it, good. Leading scorer and the Northeast Conference Player of the Year. Took until 3:42 left in the half to find the basket for the first time.
Well, we're going to see whether the ball leaves Walker's hands before the contact. It's close. McLean's going to pick up the charge against Myron Walker. They get the basket. Wayne going back down the other end. It's just two.
Walker gets the bucket and the foul. 22-18. Two-time NEC Coach of the Year, Garrett Durham, hoping his Colonials can somehow pull a stunner. McLean's missed two free throws. When's the last time that happened? Walker on the fly. And a big pileup of Bruins and a blocking foul on the
Derek Martin trying to get back, and Myron Walker is just a great leaper, great slasher, great ability. Nice fast break right here, and he just takes off, goes right into Martin. And they're going to call a block on Martin. The fouls that are being called are slowing the game up also, along with Robert Morris. As far as their offense is concerned, UCLA just can't get any tempo going.
Myron Walker, local hero out of Aliquippa, Pennsylvania. A mass substitution is coming in again for UCLA. Matkins checks back in. Carver sits down. The Walker, who took a long time to get started, has the last four Colonial points.
Two and a half minutes, they have only taken 15 field goal attempts. They need to put the ball up. We've also heard some said that the free throw line, 4 of 9, Don McLean missing two.
Starting lineup back in there for UCLA. Murray, who's been very effective, not that time. Rebound, Robert Morris. Walker clears it to Timmerson. Chance for the Colonials to tie, and if they do, this place will go crazy because the Colonials have the fans on their side. Walker. A little strong. Bilal kept it alive as it comes free out to Donnelly.
And Robert Morris, before the game, talked about letting UCLA only take one shot at the basket, and they're getting some offensive rebounds, 16-16.
Bilal over McLean. Matkin, nice quick pass to Butler, and he fouled.
Coming out of that timeout, it looks like the Bruins said, hey, let's try and run this ball.
Look at the rebound. Looking for that last missed shot by Bilal. It was dead even. Mitchell Butler goes to the free throw line. Garrett Durham's got to feel good about this so far.
Well, he slowed things down. He controlled things. That's the first attempt that the Bruins have made to run the ball.
And they clang another free throw off. They've missed three straight free throws.
As a team, UCLA is 74% from the line.
And only 4 for 10, 4 for 11 tonight.
Well, maybe Robert Morris will keep fouling if they got enough guys on the bench and put the Bruins at the line.
Another chance for Robert Morris to tie. Walker leaves it off, but a foul on Edney as Shelton Carney was trying to go to the basket. That'll be the second foul on Tyus Edney.
Foul is on number 11, Tyus Edney.
The whistle is stopping play, and UCLA, another reason why they cannot get into any momentum, but the advantage goes to Robert Morris.
Here's the free throw chart. That's the first miss by Robert Morris, who Carney can't connect. The two chances to tie have gone by the board for the Colonials. And we approach the 2 minute mark, remaining first half.
The guards for UCLA have a height advantage, especially with Gerald Matkins, but he has not been underneath that much.
McLean fouled by Maggie. Instead, number 12 reaching in, trying to help out.
You can see the defense right there trying to get the ball inside. And watch Donnelly try and help out. He slapped down, not much contact, but the fact that he slapped down instead of maybe reaching under with one hand was more a visual foul than anything else.
Bilal sits down, and Ricky Cannon checks back in for Robert Morris. Wayne, who had missed his last two free throws, and as we mentioned earlier, a 92% free throw shooter.
And that's not even a career high at UCLA. Rod Foster.
Got around 25. Ed O'Bannon checks back in, and McLean will get a rest. McLean sits with 7 points. And a 4-point Bruin lead.
Just by UCLA trying to create something, but good patience by Robert Morris. Kind of a soft press.
3-pointer on goal for Walker. Butler gets it ahead. Bruins are on a 3-on-2. Henry pulls up. Missed it. And Timmerson is fouled, trying to get out of there. Double teamed by Butler, and Madkins, the man called for the foul.
Yeah, it's not a bad shot by Tyus Edney. He just needed to stop and get a little bit more body balance, because you want your point guard coming down on break to stop around that area so you guys can fill the lanes and give them room for a dish off.
Andre Williams comes back in for the Colonials. And Donnelly goes out.
Jim Herrick is doing a lot of substituting with his Bruins, trying to find some combination, but you think you'd like to have some guys get some minutes and really see if they can gel together.
Donnelly getting a little ice on the right arm. As Timmerson hits the free throw. Wade Timmerson, 5'9 senior, can make it a one basketball game again, and he does. 24-22, UCLA. Down to a minute and a half, first half.
UCLA a bigger team, but they're just not taking advantage of their height.
O'Bannon outside. The two-pointer. He's got 4 points off the bench.
That time UCLA was chasing on their offense and freed up a guy so he had wide open shot. Let's go!
Robert Morris trying to set some picks for Myron Walker, their leading scorer. He's been kind of quiet though. Jumper won't go.
Run of reason being Gerald Manson just guarding him without the ball and not giving him an opportunity to catch it.
Derek Martin will slow it down and bring it down for the Bruins. And now UCLA, there's about a 3-second difference on the shot clock and the game clock. The shot clock right now is at 12. There, you've got them both. And we'll watch along with you as the Bruins get set to take a shot here before halftime. An air ball. And it'll be Robert Morris' ball. One chance to touch it. We've got less than a second remaining.
I don't know if that's the kind of shot that UCLA wanted. They did get it up. I wasn't sure whether it hit the rim or not.
0.9 seconds remaining. It's a touch, and then you got to get rid of it. It was Derek Martin who touched it and threw it back the other way. End of the first half. Colonials trailing by only 4. Turned some turnovers into points. And they're hanging in with the Bruins on the board, trailing by only 2 there. Brad Nessler and Ann Myers, we've got 20 minutes left. And the Bruins took about 5 minutes to score at the beginning of this game. They took about 19 and a half minutes to come back out of the locker room, man.
Well, no number one seed has lost in the first round, and UCLA, after this first half, looked in jeopardy. I look for the Bruins to come out a lot more aggressive offensively. They need to shoot the ball. Even if they miss, try and get Robert Morris into a running game. Pick up the tempo. Robert Morris did a very good job, discipline-wise, running their offense in that first half.
Bilal with a drive. They're going to wipe that one out. Well, that was a strong move by Magdy Bilal.
Well, Mitchell Butler moves over to help out weak side defense. Bilal, good job going right past John McClain, but a better job defensively by the Bruins helping out.
So now the Bruins with their first possession of the second half. guy in the court got the rebound. Gerald Matkin for three.
That's the first point by a starting backcourt player.
And it up the UCLA lead to seven, matching their biggest margin of the first half. Bubba Donnelly, he's a three-point expert in the lineup for Robert Morris. And he just got bumped by Butler. Robert Morris has to find a way to get Myron Walker involved, too. He's only 1-for-7 from the field for 4 points in the first half. And he's a guy scoring 20 a game. Timmerson, high off the glass, and he got it. Bruins by five, and almost threw it away.
Bruins just on the check. They pull it back up. They had an opportunity as far as the numbers were concerned. But don't look at the basket.
Another three-pointer. Matkins has it. 2-for-2 from outside the arc this half. And that's an 8-point Bruin advantage.
Robert Morris still slowing things down.
And an offensive foul. And this one, I think it's going to go on Walker. Two fouls for Robert Morris. McLean trying to hook pass inside, stolen away.
You know it's a throwaway. It's a lot better ball movement by the Bruins. Just trying to pick up the tempo of the game, and Robert Morris still very deliberate.
Walker had it taken away by Matkin. Ahead to Edney. The offensive rebound, and he fouled. That's going to be three on Bilal.
Bilal makes a great effort to block for his shot. Don McLean has matured a lot this year. Last year, a lot of people thought he was hot-tempered and a little frustrated. McLean, an unusual free-throw style, but it worked for him.
And it's a 10-point Bruin lead with 17 and a half minutes to play. Timmerson with a runner. And back from the Bruins. A little transition game going on. Butler again backs out though. Tracy Murray's been held scoreless this half. Whistling a foul on Donnelly. That's going to be three. On Bubba Donnelly. Over the free throw line, Mitchell Butler, still without any points in this one. He became a starter in the 17th game of the season. Missed his two free throws earlier, and he's still 0-for from the line.
Butler, not even 50%, 47.8 from the free throw line, has really struggled.
The better field goal shooter, 49% from the field, 48 as Ann said from the stripes.
UCLA, 8 of 17 from the free throw line.
34-26.
And down the stretch, that is what is going to win games for you. UCLA has not come out against Robert Morris as the number one seed, looking like one.
Turnover by the Colonials. So UCLA can go back in front by 10, and they do. There's Murray's first field goal of the second half.
UCLA has come out a little flat this game. They just don't have the intensity to just really pick themselves up. Turnovers are killing Robert Morris.
Hardy threw it away, but Timmerson got it back and got it ahead. The Walker.
the first basket by Myron Walker.
Nice shot by Tracy Murray off the glass. We approach the 16-minute mark. Bilal on the drive. That time he got it. 38-30, Bruins. That's him short this time, and Bilal got the rebound.
Don't forget, Robert Morris is a running team, and this is the kind of game UCLA wants.
Here come the Bruins. Butler can't get it, and the rebound. 15-30 remaining in this one, an 8-point Bruin lead. Let's go to Jim Nance in New York.
All right, Brad, thank you. And let's take everybody around the country. The game's in progress right now. The big story is Arizona trailing East Tennessee State, but the Wildcats are on a run, Billy.
On a very good run, and East Tennessee State now not hitting the threes like they were before. And I'm surprised they're not pulling the ball out a little bit higher, trying to make Arizona chase them a little bit. They've got a lot of foul trouble, does Arizona, with three players with four apiece.
It was 66-50, but Arizona has run off 10 straight. This is Arizona with the basketball, looking to cut into that 6-point lead. Sottlmeyer not getting the roll, and the Buccaneers have it. East Tennessee State, a 14 seed. Oh, what a save by them there, Billy. Now, UTEP and Evansville, and this is in the Midwest, an 8-9 game, and Evansville's been on a run also.
They had a 12-4 run, put themselves in a good position here in the second half.
The winner of this game will play Kansas on Sunday.
Low scoring, a lot of physical activity and hand-to-hand combat in UTEP's man-to-man defense.
Billy, back at UCLA and Robert Morris. Robert Morris has had the best showing of any 16 seed in this tournament.
Playing extremely well. I'm surprised that UCLA can't get the game a little bit higher tempo. They just haven't been able to get away from Robert Morris this entire ballgame.
Let's set it back out there. Courtside in Tempe. Here's Brad and Ann.
All right, guys. Walker got the second of his two free throws and cut UCLA's lead back to 7 with 14:40 to play. Colonials had a couple of costly turnovers, but UCLA unable to capitalize on the other end. And so the 16th seed still hanging in with number one. But Tracy Murray has really done a job. 17 for Murray.
Tracy Murray wanted a three-pointer, and they only counted two.
And Will Parcells stopped playing, goes over to the scorer's table, and I think that's what he's going to tell us. Yes.
Jared Durham wants a two-pointer and says no way.
Well, we'll get another look.
He clearly turns right on the line.
With the added point for Murray.
Hey, just hope for Robert Morris to take it. It's not a one-point game.
And Edney's going to pick up the foul at this third.
Matthias Edney has played so well for UCLA coming off the bench, and he deserves a start in this game. But you also wonder, this late going right into the NCAA tournament. Sean Tarver has been starting all year, and you bring Matthias Edney off the bench because he is that spark, and he creates so much excitement and really a cohesiveness when he comes off the bench.
Trying to become part of the offense, got a shot away with a left hand, and he was fouled.
And Joe Mackin really lost his balance. There was a kick set up way high, and Robert Morris has done a very good job setting those high kicks, and then they roll. And Joe Mackin's got his feet tripped up, and he's trying to recover, and he just went right into the offensive player, Myron Walker.
Mackin's a great defender, but he's got to be tired of chasing this guy all night. He's done a great job of it, though. Only 7 points for Walker, averaging 20. The youngest player ever to take the Northeast Conference Player of the Year honors. He's only a sophomore.
Robert Morris doing a better job getting him the basketball, but Gerald Matkins is going to find defensive job on Myron Walker, especially in that first half.
Robert Morris just keeps hanging around in this one.
And UCLA, to me, this really is not aggressive offensively. Attacking, it's a smaller zone. They ought to be trying to shoot over it, or at least go into the seams and try and create something.
Thought about a three. Edney will take it instead. And the rebound is Pinnerson.
UCLA has bigger guys out there in Tracy Murray and Don McClain. McClain really hasn't touched the ball at all. Only two free throws in the second half. And that's what Matthews does so well. He does not let Myron Walker get the basketball.
13:06 left. The top-seeded Bruins with an 8-point cushion, and Robert Morris trying to cut it to six, but stripped down. Folletta inside. Second time is good for Ricky Cannon. 41-35. UCLA. 20 for Murray. Robert Morris getting some backcourt scoring. Helped him stay within 8 of the number one seed.
Also slowing things down again in the second half against the Bruins. Spreading the defense out.
Williams in there now, along with Walker, Pemberton. This is Cannon on the drive. And they're going to call Cannon for the foul.
What happens when UCLA Bruin defense is spread out like that offensively, and if they get beat that baseline like that, they do have the opportunity, if they're watching, to help out defensively because there's so much time to make up because the offense is so spread out.
And now UCLA with Matthews, Carver, McClain, Murray, and Edney. Kick ball and a deep by 8 with 11:40 to go. Brad Nessler and Ann Myers with you in Tempe, Arizona, in our final game of the West Regional here. And the foul call inside. This one will go on Andre Williams.
John McClain in his career at UCLA has only been held to a single figure 3 times, once this year against Washington. Last year, he scored double figures every game. 2 years ago, against Louisville, he only had 9, and as a freshman, he was held to 6 points and 8 points. North Carolina and SC scored 4 times.
Baseline jumper, Carver, with his first basket of the second half. 10-point cushion again. Williams outside, guarded by Edney. I need to free up Walker. Knocked away by Murray. 15 on the shot clock for Robert Morris.
Good pressure defense by Tyus Edney.
Timmerson. Adjusts in midair and got it to go.
Great bounce by Timmerson.
10 points for Timmerson.
Cannon and McClain really leaning on each other.
McClain baseline, looking for a foul, didn't get it. Timmerson brings it back. Walker with a left hand, can't get it. Underneath, up and good for rookie Cannon.
Colonials, they just keep coming back and coming back.
And they play it tough in Pennsylvania.
Great shot by Myron Walker, switching it into his left hand, and Ricky Cannon being very aggressive on the offensive board. They know they are right there with the Bruins.
Those guys could play for the Steelers with that kind of attitude. 3-point play opportunity now for Ricky Cannon. He's a 6'8 senior out of Pittsburgh. 5-point game, folks. with just over 10 minutes to go.
UCLA is struggling offensively this whole game. UCLA trying to call out an offense. We're not sure what Robert Morris is running because nobody's moving for UCLA.
Way outside. There's Harper at the second basket from the same spot, just inside the three-point line.
John Harper has been a big lift for UCLA in this game. He has not gotten a lot of minutes, but when he's come in, he's performed.
Timmerson, nice drive. Bilal got the rebound, and he can't get it to go, but he's fouled. Free throws are not his strong suit, 50%. You can just about read Coach Durham's mind thinking, how many times have I signed the line? He got the second one. 6-point ball game. And we're under 10 minutes remaining in this one. Our final game here in the West Regional in Tempe. Two surprises today. New Mexico State over DePaul, Southwestern Louisiana. Also a winner as they picked off number 4, Oklahoma. The Sean Carver show the last two trips on court for UCLA.
I'm
not sure if he's missed the shot since he's coming to the game. The Bane, though, 1-5 in the second half. Walker works for his jumper. And the plane, the rebound. Ruined by 8 on the run. Back in, he got the 3. UCLA with its biggest lead with 8:32 to go. The top seed has stretched it out to an 11-point cushion. Including those at Pittsburgh and Duquesne, but he is really struggling here, and his team needs him the most. 8:20 to go, and Robert Morris now trails by 11.
14 out of the last 17 games, he has been the leading scorer, only 7 points in this game.
Check back in. And Shelton Carney will sit down. Matkins always scoring has come from 3-point range. 9 points on 3 plays this half. And for Matkins, the 6'4 senior.
Matkins broke a bone earlier in the year in his left hand. He had it taped up. Missed a few games.
Been kind of a mash unit his whole career. Had major pelvic surgery back in 88.
Put on a moped.
Can't 53-43. Walker. Bilal
Great hustle by Robert Morris getting the offensive board.
Timmerson can't get it. Cannon kicks back out to Donnelly. And they'll regroup with a fresh 45. And we're under 7 minutes. Cannon, nice drive with a left hand. 53-45 still, an 8-point game. UCLA's biggest lead has been 11.
Just when you think UCLA's going to go away with it, Robert Morris has tried back in on him.
Matkin has done some kind of job in this second half.
Great move, and what a little spin that Cannon puts in it to get off the glass.
But Robert Morris now can ill afford just to change baskets with UCLA, as they do here, as Matkins got three.
Byron Walker falling down. Matkins with 12 points.
10-point game, 6.5 minutes to go.
Here's that pick again by Robert Morris. UCLA just has not figured it out.
Winterson almost lost it into the backcourt. He'll take the three over McLean. And Murray the rebound. UCLA is going to use a little clock. And as we approach 6 minutes, they lead 55-45, and they lost it out of bounds.
UCLA does much better when they speed things up and are attacking and being aggressive. Coming out on a lackadaisical pass and not being aggressive. Defense, now they're speaking.
Valletta can't get it inside. Bilal comes up with a loose ball. And he takes a rare outside jumper. Offensive foul called on Martin.
Well, Derek Martin comes down with a big rebound and is going out. He kind of throws out his arm. There's not much contact. You see Donnelly kind of falling back, and they're going to call an offensive foul off of a perfect break situation for the Bruins. Slowing things down again, coming back over to Robert Morris.
And Robert Morris brings Ricky Cannon back in. Bilal sits down.
That's a key play right there, because it's a transition situation for UCLA to kind of get things going, running again, and all of a sudden, ball comes back to Robert Morris, things slow down again, and the fans are kind of in Robert Morris'
position. See if Robert Morris can make it a 4-point swing.
They have three shots at that last possession with the rebounding.
Cannon. Push underneath, and it will go on Coletta.
Falling down. There's not much contact, but it looks like an obvious grab.
Well, with a foul on Coletta, back come the Bruins to go to the free throw line.
He's playing only 9 points and 2 free throws in the second half. He's only had 1 field goal in this game. That was his first 2 points.
We're talking about a guy with 2,540, now 7 career points.
Coming into this game, he only needed 19 points to pass Sean Elliott from Arizona as the Pac-10 leading scorer.
He'll be hard-pressed to get it tonight, but he might have another day lying ahead. The winner of this one goes on to meet the Cardinals of Louisville. That'll be Southwestern Louisiana, New Mexico State, and the other bracket. Hook shot, Cannon, no good. And now Robert Morris with back-to-back fouls inside, trying to work for rebounding position, and that's not going to help.
Falling for Robert Morris. Smarter now. He's on the free throw line and he's making sure that he has a body on somebody and that they're coming over his back.
Byron Walker, the guy called with that last foul, his third. McLean has hit his last 6 after a couple of rare misses. In the mixture of his 9 successful free throws and now 10.
Well, if UCLA should win this game, they would have a rematch with Louisville. And in the game we saw before, Louisville is a much better athletic team. They like to run and jump, and UCLA is going to have to come out a lot more focused.
This is the largest lead of the night for the top seed of Bruins, 59-45. And a foul again on the rebound. Third straight time it's happened.
I'll tell you, that move by Myron Walker was a big time move coming in, and he just flies over everybody and then just keeps the ball back up off the glass.
Robert Jones will come back in, and Joe Folletta sits down. Well, there's no way Robert Morris can get back in this ball game by letting the top free throw shooter in the country go back and be 15 feet away every time and do that. 7 points this half, 14 for the game, and 12 of those have come from the free throw line.
13 of 15 from the free throw line.
UCLA on a 12-2 run, and they stretched it out to a 16-point advantage. Big pile up at midcourt. Jump ball, and the possession will be UCLA.
Sean Carver, who has hit some big shots for UCLA offensively, is a very good defensive player and created that in the middle.
Now they're going to clean up the middle where that big train wreck occurred. And the Bruins with their biggest lead. That was their biggest player that you were looking at. Michael Heater, all 7 foot 6 inches of him.
Has a twin brother playing at Colorado.
Murray kicks back out. Martin and jumper go.
That's the first time in a half-court game that UCLA has run something quick. Good passes, and opened up the shot.
And a timeout. Three doesn't go, and with just a little over 4 minutes now, as you see the clock on the corner. Time running out on the 16th-seeded Colonials with Robert Morris, who hung tough with the number one seed in the West. For the better part of 30 minutes, really, of basketball.
Well, now it's UCLA's turn to hold the basketball. It's
not a matter of
controlling the
tempo.
Just wasting time off the clock.
And lost the handle. Robert Jones picks up the loose ball, and Tennyson gets it ahead to Walker. I think Walker's ejected too many shots tonight. Ball still loose. Finally, Ricky Cannon gets it out to Walker again. That time he can square up, and he buried it. Lane lobs in to Mitchell. East Tennessee State trying to pull off an upset over the number 3 seed in the Southeast region, Arizona.
Wade Timmerson stepping over the baseline. 5'9"
Only seen this one tonight. See that team hang in with UCLA until the late stages of this one.
I think it's Robert Morris a lot of credit, and I know that they don't want it. They would rather have a W coming in here.
The Bruins of UCLA. Down the lane, 13 of 15, 14 of 16 at the free throw line.
Nine of those scores in the second half, all from the free throw line. Only one field goal for Don McClain in this game.
He's going to come out of this if you just kind of grab the paper in the morning and say, hey, Don McClain at 17 for the Bruins. But really, offensively, he was not that big a factor except when he was sent to the stripe by Robert Morris.
But did a pretty good job at the end as far as rebounding was concerned on the defensive end and put himself at the free throw line.
Cannon's too strong. And McClain, another rebound that Andrew talked about. 20-point Bruin lead, final 2.5 minutes. And Don McClain needs just 2 points, and he's in the record books again. And when once it looked like he'd have to wait till Sunday to get it, he still may get it before this one's over. On the shot clock.
You're taking the
nice drive by Derek Martin with about five on the shot clock. He went up with the left hand and got it.
Whether that intensity level is there, whether they're flat, they've got to come up hot against Louisville. And I know that the Cardinals are excited to have the rematch this year. The last time those two teams met in the NCAAs was 1980 in the finals, where Louisville beat UCLA.
For the national championship. Under a minute and a half to go. Cannon doesn't get it on the baseline. Walker does with a follow. So Walker now with 15 points. But they have not been that effective with 15 points. When normally he's the guy that just takes control for the Colonials. That wasn't the case tonight. 5 out of 17 from the field, in fact, for Myron Walker. Under a minute. And a foul on Timmerson. So the Colonials were on probation and ineligible for NCAA play last year. But who had been around the previous two seasons. This is their third appearance in the last 4 years. And you got to give them credit against a highly favored UCLA team. They made it a ball game for a good portion of it, but it's the Bruins now in command, 69-49. And here's the guy I think was the difference for UCLA.
You know, Madsen's in the second half, all 15 points right now. In the second half, not scoring the first half. We talked about the guard play as far as any kind of point production from the Bruins, which they did not have, but defensively, he really checked Myron Walker down.
He hit three gigantic three-pointers that really kind of broke the game open for UCLA. 16 points for Madsen. And he'll go to the bench, and he'll get a glad hand from his teammates because he's done his work tonight. Free throw line is Wade Timmerson. 7 rebounds and 5 assists to go with his 10 points tonight. Number 2 in career assists all time. And playing in his final minute as a college basketball player. Shot clock off now. That's the game clock in the corner. It's 71-51 UCLA, all set to advance here in the West Region. They'll be taking on Louisville. And the other matchup, a couple upstarts who pulled upset today. New Mexico State and Southwestern Louisiana. Zip it! Big George has a basket in the NCAA tournament. 73-51. Bubba Donnelly can't get it. Joe Folletta kicks it outside and on the drive for the basket. The final one of the ball game was Shelton Carney. The top seeded UCLA got a little bit of a scare from number 16 seeded Robert Morris, but Jim Herrick's troops will go on to another day.
They can start.